Greetings, and welcome back to Strike Fighters 2 Vietnam, flying F-8 Crusaders with VF-211 off the USS Hancock, following now Lieutenant Commander Devin Horner. After a surprising promotion in our first mission in this new campaign, in the last video, we are here on 6th of March, 1966, which is now 5 days after the previous mission that we flew, and we're gonna get our first taste of real air combat today. We're to escort a friendly flight on its mission to, oh man, Tac Zone Za. Sorry if I butchered that. Not familiar with those pronunciations. We're gonna protect the Cowboy Flight, which is going to be 8 A-4 Skyhawks from enemy interceptors. We're gonna be callsign Oyster, and we're gonna be taking 4 Crusaders, launch time of 7:52 in the morning. Not a whole lot to look at here in the loadout. Just sidewinders for everybody. 4 sidewinders. No drop tanks available, even on Crusaders. So we just go with what we've got, and then we've got our guns, which is at 100% ammo, and our sidewinders, and that's for all 4 aircraft. Looking at the map, we're coming into this KFAT region again. Very, very close. This is going to be, let's see, initial point is going to be 6,800 feet. This is only 6 minutes after takeoff where we're scheduled to be here. So it's going to be very, very quick. And then we're going to come in to the objective point at about 7,000 feet and then head out. Well, plan to head out. We may end up fighting over this airspace here. We'll see what kind of interceptors are out there looking for us and our buddies. Quick look at the roster. My immediate wingman is going to be Ensign Dixon again. The second element is going to be led by Lieutenant Chansey, and his wingman will be J.G. Stark. All right, so that's everything. This is exciting. I'm a little nervous at the same time. Hopefully we're up to the task here and we'll be able to shoot down some MiGs. So, we'll see you up on the flight deck, and we're going to get going here on our second mission with VF-211 checkmates. Full power from the chute officer. Thumbs up, salute. There goes 2. 1 is away. The second element of the flight isn't even up yet, and we're getting calls that bandits have been spotted at 6 o'clock.
Oyster, leave. Red ground. Multiple bogeys. 6 o'clock. 50 miles.
VF-211, known as the Fighting Checkmates, is a Navy squadron that was established in 1945 at the now-defunct Otis Airfield on Cape Cod in Massachusetts. It was originally VB-74, a bombing squadron flying helldivers. By the end of the year, the squadron had switched to AD-1 Sky Raiders, been redesignated VA-24, and relocated to Naval Air Station Norfolk. VA-24 became VF-24 after engine problems with the Sky Raiders prompted a switch to Corsairs, and the squadron made 3 deployments to the Korean War. The squadron saw a series of first-generation fighter jets through the 1950s, F-9F Panthers, the FJ Fury, F-3H Demons, F-11F Tigers, and finally the F-8 Crusader. In 1959, the squadron switched designations with the original VF-211 checkmates. This new VF-211 now moved to Naval Air Station Miramar in 1961, and there they would remain for 35 years. VF-211 made 8 deployments to Vietnam, all in Crusaders. 7 of the cruises were aboard the USS Hancock, while the 1967 deployment was with the USS Bonhomme Richard. VF-211 had 8 confirmed kills, earning them a reputation as the MiG Killers. Lieutenant J. Tucker of VF-211 had the final Crusader kill of the war in 1972, though it is disputed because the MiG pilot ejected before Tucker fired his Sidewinder. The last MiG kill VF-211 officially claimed was in July 1967, when Lieutenant Commander Ray Hubbard Jr. took down a MiG-17 with a pair of Zuni rockets after forcing the MiG pilot to overshoot using some very tricky flying. In 1975, the squadron transitioned to the brand new F-14 Tomcat, and would retain the type for almost 30 years. They made Pacific deployments, known as Westpacs, on board the Constellation, Ranger, Kitty Hawk, and Nimitz through the 70s, 80s, and early 90s, until in 1996, the Navy moved off Miramar Base and handed it over to the Marines. At that time, VF-211 was restationed to Naval Air Station Oceana in Virginia Beach and began East Coast deployments. I was introduced to the squadron in late 2003 when they came aboard the Enterprise as part of Carrier Air Wing 1, and we sailed for the Middle East for Operation Iraqi Freedom. This was the squadron's final cruise with Tomcats, and I was able to take a ton of still photos of them in action on the flight deck. On February 2, 2004, just as we were getting ready to head home from deployment, two F-14s collided with one another while practicing basic daytime fighter maneuvers, with the wingman hitting the wing of the leader. The right vertical stabilizer from the bottom Tomcat was completely torn away, also damaging the right engine. The leader had a wingtip that was bent down. The carrier maneuvered at flank speed into position to recover the stricken aircraft. Worried about hydraulic damage or unknown aerodynamic effects of the damage, both planes made no-flap landings. They both caught the wire successfully and nobody was injured. The leader aircraft, number 104, was repaired, approved by Grumman Ironworks, and was returned to service. The second plane, however, number 111, was written off as unrepairable. 111 was moved to a dark corner of the hangar bay, and the damage was covered up with a silver tarp, though it was still clear that part of the tail was missing. That aircraft stayed on board until we got back to Norfolk and was craned off. For 14 years now, I have thought that I missed witnessing an emergency barricade capture. You may remember me alluding to this in some earlier videos. The story we heard down in the bowels of the ship was that the leader aircraft had lost all hydraulics and had to land into the net. The plane had then been stripped and pushed overboard like something out of World War II. Wanting to confirm this story, I posted in the Enterprise Veterans group that I'm in on Facebook, and amazingly enough, the pilot of the lead aircraft responded. He said, "Groundhog Day. I'll never forget it. I was in the lead aircraft. How about the power of the internet, huh?" So he gave me the details of what happened to the aircraft, and using that I was able to research a little bit more, and I am grateful that he set my story straight, because the barricades were never used, and I didn't actually miss anything. All other than seeing some really banged up F-14s landing, of course. Immediately after we returned to the States, VF-211 retired the F-14s and transitioned to the brand new F-18EF Super Hornets. After I left in 2006, the squadron remained with Carrier Air Wing 1 and deployed with the Enterprise until her retirement in 2012. The squadron is still attached to CVW-1 and flies Super Hornets off the USS Harry Truman CVN-75. There's our A-4s right there as we're reaching the rendezvous point. Alright, radar is lighting up now with aircraft about 10 miles out. There's our Skyhawks.
Oyster 1. Red ground. Bandit. Left 11 o'clock. 10 miles. Angel 5. Heading south.
5.
He's burning and going down.
Red ground. Cowboy lead. 5 minutes to our target.
Cowboy 1. Red ground. Copy that.
All right, we've hit the initial point for the A-4s. They're heading into their target now. Skyhawks taking fire from the ground. We've certainly been there before.
Red ground, Dallas, speed, passing, waypoint 5.
Dallas, 1, red ground, copy.
Oh, look at that. They took out that bridge. Well, good. Mission accomplished for them. Those are the closest fighters we have.
I'm hit!
Fox 1! I've got a spike!
Fox 2!
Who is this?
I'm out of ammo.
That's a Crusader. And that's also a Crusader.
Red crown, Mamba lead, passing waypoint 7.
Mamba 1, red crown. Copy, Oyster 1, red crown. 20 plus bandits. 12 o'clock, 10 miles. Angel 5, heading northwest.
I'm out of ammo. Blast! Target destroyed! Fox 2.
I've got Winchester.
Oyster, lead. Red crown. Bandit. Left 7 o'clock. 20 miles. Angel 25. Heading southeast.
A lot of gun ammo! Target hit! Fox 2.
They're those MiGs.
Copy. I'm here!
MiGs are attacking our A-4s as they're trying to escape the area. I can see the tracers being fired up there. We've got to get up there and save them. I've got tone on someone. I can't see the MiGs in the storm, but let's hope they're closest to me. Fox 2! Damn, didn't track. It's going ballistic. No! Those are our A-4s calling out that they're under attack. Hey, Flight 1, engage air, please. And Wingman, cover me. Can't see anything in this freaking fog. Okay, we're coming in close on this guy. Switching to guns. Come on, come on. Fox 2. Fucking got him. And we're taking fire from behind. Dude, cover me. Well, no shit. All right, we're going to go vertical with this. We may only have one engine, but we still have a better power ratio than the MiGs do. Easier for us to go. Oh! Good job. Thank you. Someone's shooting up to my left. Box 2. Yes! All right, what's next? We got a J5. Head on pass with this J5. Let's try to low yo-yo up under him as he makes the turn. Go back up over the top instead. Guy had blue eyes. All right. We're getting real low, and this turning fight with the MiG is not working. In a slow turn, the MiG has us, but above 450 knots, they can't turn. So we have to use speed and climb against them if we can. Alright, man, wingman. Get my target. I'm gonna string him along. You take him down. How are we doing on fuel? Oh, I got plenty. As I'm just leaving it firewalled. There, we've opened the distance. Now we're going to turn back in on him and close that distance once again. See if he's still pointed at me or if he's engaging somebody else. But we got almost 500 knots to work with now. Where are you going, buddy? What are you doing? Pull up, bleed off some of that speed. Blacking out now. Picking up flak from the coastline now, like I need that. Where the hell is Ensign Dixon? Come on, get this guy. Oh, looks like maybe he just got hit a little bit. Thought I saw. Whew! Head on pass in the vertical. That was interesting. There's Dixon trying to get an angle on this guy. Let's see if I can come up under him. Oh, we're getting real slow. Oh no. Is he shooting at Dixon? That could work to our advantage. That'll keep him occupied. We can get a missile in on him now. Alright, he's turning to the right, trying to get an angle on Dixon. Box 2! Son of a bitch, it didn't track. Alright, switching to guns on this boy. Not freaking... Fuck you, buddy! Holy crap. Let's rejoin, please. How are we looking?
Point, sir, one. Red ground.
Oh, man.
Left, 7 o'clock, 25 miles. Angel, 10, heading north.
Nope. 25 miles. They're out of range, and they're bugging out home. So, time for us to disengage as well. We still have all of our 4 aircraft after all that. Let's make sure that they stay with us. I see that Oyster 3 is actually over the coast still. Well, good thing we're going home, buddy. Heart is still pounding after all that. That fight felt like it took an hour. But I'll bet when we look back later a little, it'll only be a few minutes. The average MiG-Dog fight in Vietnam was around 45 seconds. Okay. And there's the fleet about 25 miles away from us. In combat, our most effective fighting force is the two-plane element. We saw how I kept Dixon with me through the beginning of the fight until I needed him to get that bandit off me. And then he took the guy down. Then at the end, we switched places. The bandit was following Dixon, and I returned the favor of clearing his tail. I was able to get in behind him while he was leading the MiG along as bait, essentially. Using the two-man element to clear each other at 6 o'clock, that's how we want to do business here. Meanwhile, our other two-man element, led by Lieutenant Clancy, broke off, and the two of them were engaging targets of their own in the same way. Two out of four missile hits today. Actually, beat the odds on these Sidewinders. Remember last mission when I said that Sidewinders of this era only had a 16% chance to hit. So I just got 50% today. So it's my lucky day. Again, just the electronics of the day were just not reliable. Tube electronics, easily disrupted or damaged by vibration, high G, humidity, you know, who knows. Well, there's Cowboy Flight. Some of them may have come under attack from those MiGs before we were able to stop them, but I think that most of them remain. Hopefully none of them actually took any hits. Right, and my wingmen have peeled off. They're getting set up for their approach. We're about to be passing right by the cowboy squadron here. Let's see if we can see them. There they are. They're all lined up for landing.
Oyster, leave.
Let's do lights on because of this terrible weather. And we're coming over the top of the Hancock right now. There we go. hook is down, air brakes are coming out, making our break, and descending down to 1,000 feet for pattern altitude. There we go, on the downwind leg now. Passing by the carrier. Just coming abeam of the landing area. Gear is down, there's our variable incidence wing coming up again. You saw the speed brake come in. Very little clearance between the ground and the bottom of the Crusader. So that speed brake comes in, so it doesn't get all smashed up. From pictures I've seen, it looks like in real life you could extend the brake with the gear down, but in the game it interlocks it. So as soon as you drop the gear, the speed brake animates going back up. So here we are, we're 1 mile from touchdown. ILS is showing centerline, we're coming in. I can see the landing area. Hornet is calling the ball. With less than a mile to go. Little high there. Also keeping that 150 knots for approach, which is still extremely fast for this little deck. Correcting to the left. And touchdown, catching the wire. And I'm just going to quickly fold up this plane, make room for my landing. Wingmates, and I will see you down below deck in the debriefing. Alright, good flight out there today, even though the weather was terrible, making it very hard to see. Our objective was to escort those 8 A-4s, and 7 of the cowboy aircraft reached their target. One of them must have been shot down before they got there. Because we didn't encounter any resistance until after the target, so that's weird, but that's okay. So, 7 aircraft reached their target. We shot down 6 additional enemy aircraft. That's great. For no losses of Crusaders. So, 4 of us, we were able to take down 6 aircraft. And we'll take a look at the log, or the stats real quick, and see who did what. So we got an outstanding success, score of 2300. Okay, Lieutenant Commander Horner got 1 kill with the guns. That was that last MiG-17. Fired a lot and did not hit much. 2 Sidewinder kills. We fired 4 of the Sidewinders with 2 hits. Pretty good. Ensign Dixon fired some guns, no hits. Lieutenant Chansey got 3 kills himself also. Good for you, Lieutenant Chansey. Man, that's great. And he fired 576 rounds for 1 kill and then got 2 Sidewinders. So, yeah. Excellent. Take a look at the roster here. That's our first 3 air-to-air kills of our career. As a lieutenant commander, we finally get our first 3. And that's all in one mission. 2 more and we're officially an ace. And as you can see, there are no other aces in the squadron so far. Although Chansey now has 3. He's moved quite along, so good for him. Whew. So, another crazy one. A lot going on. Hopefully I wasn't babbling too much. I honestly don't remember what I was saying half the time. During the turning fight, I'm more worried about getting my target than having commentary. So I hope everyone is okay with that. And I hope you enjoyed this one. And we'll see you next time for more flying and fighting with VF-211 and Lieutenant Commander Horner. All right, see you next time.